Welcome to an example of finding a determinant of a 3x3 matrix using the cofactor method. Before we start, let's go over some vocabulary. First, the minor of any element is a determinant formed by deleting the row and column of that specific element. So for example, if we consider the element in row 1, column 2, or this element here, its minor, or m sub 1, comma 2, for row 1, column 2, is equal to the determinant formed by deleting the row and column of this element. So if we eliminate row 1 and column 2, notice how it leaves four elements. So the 2x2 determinant would have elements D, F, G, I. Next, the cofactor for any element using capital C is equal to negative 1 raised to the power of I plus J, where I is the row of the element and J is the column of the element, times its minor. So if we wanted the cofactor of element B, which is in row 1, column 2, we would have C sub 1 comma 2 is equal to negative 1 raised to the power of 1 plus 2, which would be to the third power, times its minor, which is M sub 1 comma 2. Now that we know what the minor and cofactor are, we can use the cofactor method to find the determinant of a 3x3 matrix. To calculate the determinant of a 3x3 matrix, we multiply each element in any row or column by its cofactor. The sum of these products is equal to the determinant. So going back to our example, the first step is to determine which row or column we want to use to find our determinant. And because none of the elements are zero, it really doesn't matter. So let's go ahead and work our way across this first row using the cofactor method. So the determinant of matrix A is going to be equal to the first element in row 1, which is 3, times negative 1 raised to the power of the sum of the row and column of this element. Well, this element is in row 1, column 1. 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. We're going to multiply this by the 2x2 determinant formed by eliminating the row and column of the element 3. So if we eliminate row 1 and column 1, notice how we're left with these four elements here for our 2x2 determinant. So we have negative 2, 5, 4, 1. And now we're going to move to the next element in row 1. So we'll have plus, the next element is positive 1, times negative 1 raised to the power of the row plus the column of this element. Well, this element is in row 1, column 2. 1 plus 2 is equal to 3. We're going to multiply this by the 2x2 determinant formed by eliminating the row and column of this element 1. So we're going to eliminate row 1 again, but now eliminate column 2, leaving us with the elements negative 1, 5, 2, 1. Plus, the last element in this row is positive 2. We're going to multiply this by negative 1 raised to the power of the row plus the column of this element. Well, the element 2 is in row 1, column 3. 1 plus 3 is equal to 4. And we're going to multiply this by the 2x2 determinant formed by eliminating the row and column of this element. Well, this element 2 is in row 1, column 3, leaving us with the 2x2 determinant with elements negative 1, negative 2, 2, 4. And now we'll simplify. Well, negative 1 squared is going to be positive 1. Positive 1 times 3 is 3. Now to evaluate this 2x2 determinant, we would have negative 2 times 1 minus 5 times 4. Well, negative 2 times 1 is negative 2. Minus 20 would be negative 22. Looking at the next product, we have negative 1 to the third. That's negative 1 times 1, so that's plus negative 1, or just minus 1, times our 2x2 determinant, which again would be negative 1 times 1 minus 5 times 2. Well, negative 1 times 1 is negative 1. Minus 10 would be negative 11. Next we have negative 1 to the 4th, that's positive 1, times 2, so we'll have plus 2 times the value of our determinant, which would be negative 1 times 4 minus
negative 2 times 2.
Well, negative 1 times 4 is negative 4, and then minus negative 2 times positive 2, that's minus negative 4 plus 4. Negative 4 plus 4 would be 0. So we have negative 66 plus 11 plus 0. This is equal to negative 55. So the determinant of matrix A is equal to negative 55. Remember, we can also represent a determinant using vertical bars. So using the 9 elements of the original matrix, we can also say the determinant in this form equals negative 55. Okay, we'll take a look at a second example in the next video. I hope you found this helpful.